Hello everyone. I hope you're all well on this lovely April afternoon. Now the Parkland shooting. I'd like to have a bit of a chat about that. It's a topic that I actually haven't paid that much attention to since it happened. I mean, in Australia, we don't really care about guns as sort of a cultural talking point. You know, we don't have a Second Amendment. We don't have an emotional attachment to them as a nation. So the only time we really talk about guns is when there's a mass shooting in America. But since that particular mass shooting, there's been quite a bit of activity. There's been a big anti-gun push from some of the survivors, the March for Our Lives things, a lot of media attention, etc. Which is fine, you know, good for them. They're utilizing their freedom of speech. But there's been one name that I've heard of more and more of late, and not in ways that I would like, and that is David Hogg. We need to have a talk about David Hogg. Now, he is one of the survivors from Parkland, and he's been very outspoken in the media against gun violence, etc., etc., etc. But of all the survivors, he's the one that, kind of from my observation, seems to be making more of an industry out of it than anything else. I've watched recently, I watched a few of his interviews, a few read quite a few of his tweets, and he just I don't think he's doing his cause any good for a number of reasons. He come across, first of all, he comes across as extremely self-righteous, more so than your average leftist, actually, and that's saying something. He's very he strikes me as the kind of latte sipping leftist who thinks that their opinion is better than everyone else's and that they're the enlightened class and everyone else is scum. And you know, I've got to give the kid credit. He's very brave and he survived a really horrible event, but he's just not going about it the right way. And I don't find him entirely credible. I mean, one example of this kind of self-righteous, borderline self-serving, probably egomaniacal attitude is the fact that when he was on Bill Maher a little while ago, he bragged about the fact that the White House had called him and he hung up on them, just flat out hung up. And the reasons he gave, he said that they called him to organize something, but he wouldn't let them finish and left them with the message that you know, they, you know, as in the survivors, they didn't need to listen to Donald Trump. Donald Trump had to listen to them. And he had to, Donald Trump had to listen to, and I quote, "the screams of the children and the screams of the nation." And then he hung up. So this is the problem that presents. You got this kid, David Hogg, saying he wants to make this huge change in the US, like this sort of huge agenda that he has. But then the single body, the one single body that can actually instigate this change, calls him. He doesn't call them. They call him. They want to engage with him, with his views, with his perspective. And he hangs up on them, leaving them with some sort of corny, kind of banal message, which really, I mean, it's problematic, as the left would like to say, because all it does is give the impression that he's more interested in making trendy political statements that will sound good on left-wing TV shows than actually making the change that he wants to see in his country. So he started to get on my nerves just a little bit the more and more I pay attention to him. Now, what really got my attention over the last week or so is his behavior after Laura Ingraham of Fox News tweeted an article written about him that mocked the fact that he had posted on social media that he didn't get into four colleges. Now I read the article. In the scheme of hit pieces, it was pretty banal. Like it was, you know, it wasn't that personal. It was sort of kind of ironic, and all it did was make fun of the fact that he posted something quite stupid on social media, because who cares what college he got into? And I don't know, as a millennial, I don't understand why the next generation, Generation Z, wants to put every single minute detail of their lives, even information like that, which is quite personal and should be private, out into the public sphere. But I think they just have no idea what privacy is because they live online, which actually isn't their fault. But putting that issue aside, that's a whole nother video. Basically, yeah, his reaction to this, like the rest of us when we get rubbish written about us would be should have just been to go, okay, whatever. That's what I do. I've had really crappy things written about me. I know, and I've got nowhere near the profile that he does currently. I know so many journalists have had the most shockingly slanderous, defamatory, personal things written about them in the media, and we all just go, who cares? Who cares? But he didn't do that. He had a very disproportionate, shall we say, reaction to this in the fact that he went after her advertisers. So when that article went out, he posted lists of all her advertisers on his Twitter account and encouraged these companies to pull their support, so costing her revenue, and thus with the intention to deplatform her. And what really surprised, that's not very surprising behavior from him, okay, to be honest, like he's 17, he's got it into this head, and he's got this totally falsified view of his place in the world in his head, and it's probably something that he would do. But what surprised me was that the advertisers went with it. Like these big, because like Laura's lost a dozen advertisers or more since then. So you've got these big companies who are headed by boards of presumably adults, you know, running these big industries, who jumped and did this because this kid told them to, for no other reason than Laura had hurt his feelings somewhat. You know, that just beggars belief. You know, it's the power of the outrage cycle or the media cycle or whatever. But anyway, Laura sort of lost all these sponsors, and this kid David Hogg keeps encouraging people to tweet these companies more and more and get more of them to pull out. Now the reason this irritates me somewhat is that it doesn't do David Hogg any good for obvious reasons, because it lumps him in with the rest of the regressive left, who think that their view is the only view that should matter, is the only correct thing that people should think. So if anyone either deviates from it or critiques it in some way, they deserve to be not just silenced, but punished for the actual act of doing so. And it's quite scary. And the other problem with David in this situation is that Laura actually apologized to him, which was a terrible idea for two reasons. Firstly, because she actually didn't do anything wrong. She didn't say anything really terrible or defamatory. And two, if you apologize to these kinds of people, it only encourages them. It encourages them, which is the last thing we want, because it validates their kind of self-imposed status as these moral custodians of all the goodness in the world, who can punish anyone that they don't like or that says things that they don't like. Just never apologize to them unless you've really done something wrong. He wouldn't accept the apology, of course, but the way he put it on Twitter, because everything happens on Twitter nowadays, he said that he wouldn't accept the apology unless Fox News acknowledged or something the way that they had allegedly treated him and his friends through this whole thing, and that, and I quote, he said that it's time to love thy neighbor, not mudsling at children. Now that right there is the biggest problem with David Hogg. He has, over the last few weeks, posited himself as this political force to be reckoned with, who is sharing the same platform as adults and they should therefore be treated like an adult. That's fine, okay? He's brave. Good for him for putting himself out there for what he believes in. However, he can't hide, therefore, behind the mantle of adolescence whenever someone is mean to him. Okay, you can't just do that. You put yourself out there as an adult to be treated as an adult. You've got to take it when people treat you like you're an adult. You can't have it both ways. It's the same as feminists who hurl the most appalling insults at people, but then cry sexism when people go, oh yeah, and throw it back. You can't have your cake and eat it too, as I guess the saying goes. But it just proves that this kid is still in this very kind of high school mentality, which is not surprising because he is a high school student. So that is really what irritates me about David Hogg. I think he's not doing his cause any good. He's not doing his image any good. He's going on all these sort of left-wing talk shows and saying the same thing over and over again about how everyone is being so divisive and we need to love each other. And then he goes and behaves in a completely hateful way. when someone does something he doesn't like. Okay? Nobody is immune to meanness. Nobody is immune to critique. And by going after Laura Ingraham's advertisers in an attempt to deplatform her, David Hogg has proved that he believes he is immune to both. Thank you very much. I hope you enjoy the rest of your afternoons, evenings, mornings, whatever time it is in the world, and I will speak to you soon.